Hello students, today we will be going to learn about the mathematical logics and laws of logics. In the last class we have learned about the tautology, contradiction and contingency. Now we are going to learn about the mathematical logics and laws of logics and related problems. So what is logical equivalence and laws of logic? So logical equivalence, what it says, when two compound propositions have the same truth values, no matter what truth value their constituent propositions have, they are called logically equivalent. For instance, P implies Q and not P or Q are logically equivalent, and we can write it as P implies Q logically equivalent to not P or Q. That is, here the equivalent symbol, this symbol says it is logically equivalent. So this is a logically equivalent symbol. So for example, how to prove? We have P and Q, two propositions. P implies Q, they have mentioned, and not P, we'll have to take, and not P or Q, we'll have to consider whether these two compound propositions are equivalent. So if you put the values for P and Q, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1 are with the four combinations of values. P implies Q, it is 1, 1, it is 0, and it is 1. So not P, in a sense, negation of the P, it will become 1, 1, 0, 0. And we'll be have not P or Q, we'll have to consider this and this. This will become 1, 1, again it is 0 and 1. So if you consider this as well as this, both are same. So both are equivalent. We can say P and Q, this and not P or Q are equivalent. And we can say it is logically equivalent by putting this symbol. So same way, to prove this logical equivalence for a compound proposition, so we'll be having set of rules, that is, we can say that laws of logics. So we have 10 laws were introduced here to prove the correctness of the logical statement. Our first law is law of double negation. Here they have given a law of double negation for a single proposition. For example, for any proposition, they have mentioned, like, for any proposition P, for any proposition P, law of double negation, what it says? So law of double negation says that not of P is logically equivalent to P. Suppose if we have any doubt, we can prove this. Suppose we have truth table. We can draw a truth table for this. So with the value P and not P, again not of not P. So P is the number 0 and 1. Not of this P is 1 and not of this P is 0. And again we'll be performing not of this, that is 0 and 1. So if you consider this as well as this, both the values are same. So hence the law is applicable. So not of not P is equivalent to P itself. The same way we have De Morgan's law. De Morgan's law is for any two proposition. For any two propositions, I'll consider two propositions as P and Q. P and Q, it says, our first rule says, not of P and Q will be logically equivalent to not P or not Q. And second rule says, not of P or Q is logically equivalent to not P and not Q. Same way we have the third rule, that is commutative law. This is also for two propositions P and Q. For any two propositions P and Q, this is for any two propositions P and Q, this will become P and Q, this is the first rule, is logically equivalent to Q and P, will be interchanging. And second rule says P or Q is logically equivalent to Q or P. Same way we have the third rule, that is, third next law, that is associative law. This is also for two propositions. I mean, for sorry, this is for three propositions P and Q and R. We'll be considering three propositions P, Q, and R. So first rule says for any three propositions P, Q, R. Suppose the propositions are like this. This is logically equivalent. We can put a bracket for the first two propositions P or Q or R. And second rule says P and Q and R, this is logically equivalent to P and Q and R. Same way we have distributive law, this is also for three propositions P, Q and R, P, Q and R. This will become, suppose the proposition is like this, P or Q and R. So here the symbol is opposite. See here R symbol is there, here and symbol is there. This is logically equivalent to P or Q and P or R. Same way we will be having the second rule here, second law for distribution, that is P and Q or R. If it is the case, then this will become P and Q or P and R. This is the next rule. And then we'll be having the idempotent law. This is for single proposition. For any single proposition, we'll be having the idempotent law, that is equivalent to, see, P or P. This is logically equivalent to P itself. P and P, this is logically equivalent to P. So we have two rules here. This is first rule, this is second rule. This is for any single proposition. For any proposition P, we'll be having the rule like this. Next, we'll be having the identity rules. Identity law, what it says that we'll be having the, suppose for any single proposition, P and for tautology T naught, and for contradiction F naught, the rule becomes what? First rule says P or F naught is logically equivalent to P. Second rule says that P and T naught is logically equivalent to P. This is about the identity law. Same way we have the inverse law. Inverse law says the same way for any proposition P and for a contradiction F naught and for a tautology T naught. So first rule says that P and not P is the contradiction. And the same way we have P or not P is logically equivalent to T naught. P and not P is F naught. P or not P is T naught. This is inverse law. So same way we have domination law and absorption law. So first we'll see a domination law. This is also for any proposition P as well as for a contradiction F naught, as for a tautology T naught. The law goes, first rule is P or T naught is logically equivalent to T naught. Second rule says P and F naught is logically equivalent to F naught. Same way we have absorption law. This is also one of the important law. So this is for two propositions P and Q. The law says, first rule says P or Q is logically equivalent to P. And second rule says P and Q logically equivalent to These are the absorption law, and these are the 10 laws which is applicable to solve the problems depending on the which is under laws of logic. So we'll see the problem here, that is simplify the following compound proposition using laws of logic. That is, whatever the rules we studied, by applying that rules we'll have to solve this problem. So the given problem is P or Q and not of not P and Q. This is the given problem. We'll have to apply the laws of logic. So how to solve this? So this given problem is logically equivalent. We can simplify this as P or Q as it is, and we can apply here, see, law, De Morgan's law for this. This not is for entire flower bracket, so we can reduce this to not of not P or not Q. This is the, since it is according to the, we'll be writing comma here, De Morgan's law, because of the De Morgan's law. Same way, this is logically equivalent. We can further apply some other rule to simplify this, P or Q, and here not and not will be equals to P itself, double negation, and not Q. So I'll be writing this as, since law of double negation, since the law of double negation, this double negation will be eliminated. Now you consider, we can simplify further. See, we'll be considering this as my P, this as my Q, and here also this P is there, and I'll consider this part as R. So I'll consider this is my P and this is P and Q. If I consider in this way, I can apply the distributive law. So the rule, this statement becomes, the distributive law says P, the R symbol is as it is, and Q and R, instead of R here it is not Q. So this is according to the distributive law. Since distributive law, we have already studied this law, distributive. So now you see here, this is logically equivalent to P. We know that Q and not Q, because of inverse law, it is F naught. P or Q and not Q, this will become F naught since inverse law. Same way, P or F naught. P or F naught is logically equivalent to P. So this is my answer. Why it is logically equivalent to P? P or F naught is because of identity law. We know that P or F naught is logically equivalent to P because of identity law. This is my solution. This is the logical equivalence. By applying the logical equivalence, we have simplified the given problem. So consider this problem as an assignment, and you can simplify by yourself. In this session, we have studied about the laws of logics and different laws and related problems. And in the next session, we'll be learning about the rules of inferences. Thank you. Happy learning.